Okay, so I thought I would do a quick puppy update on the puppies. They're actually going to be 4 weeks old on Saturday, but I'll do another thing for them at 4 weeks old. So this is Jelly Bean. She's gonna be ours. And then the one over there, Splooting, is Aussie. They are holding their heads up and playing, starting to play around a little bit, exercising their back legs finally. Still haven't figured out how to get their legs completely up underneath them, but you can see he is working on it. They should have had it by now, but because they are so fat, they haven't really gotten it yet. But they do have teeth, and Piper is starting to try to start weaning them herself. So they are going to start getting fed some soft puppy food this week, regardless of whether or not they are up on all fours. And I'll start letting her out. They don't need the food in the morning time anymore. So I will start letting her out like when my husband goes to work. I'll start letting her out, and then letting her stay out, and then we'll start feeding them an hour or so later when they start getting nice and hungry. And we're going to start that way with feeding, and probably then keep, normally with a slow wean, what I would do is I would give them food, and then I would let her come in, clean them up, feed them, because normally the first couple feedings, they don't really eat very much because it's basically liquid, and they're only about 2 weeks old at that point. But since they're going to be 4 weeks old, I'm going to keep her away from them until about noon every day. Let her come in and feed at noon, and then probably keep her away from them again until later that afternoon, and I'll feed them again later that afternoon. So they'll go straight into having two feedings instead of one feeding. And then she'll basically get to stay with them all night long after that point. That's just going to encourage them to start exercising their legs a little bit more, start playing a little bit more, and not getting near as much milk from her. So that way they aren't so fat and they can stop splooting. I got to fix their... constantly fixing this because Piper messes with it and scratches it all up, and then the poor puppies can't, they don't get any traction on the green part. So I try to keep them where they're just on the blanket, but it's Piper messes it up. But once I have Piper out for most of the day, they'll start, they'll have more traction and they'll do better. They are getting around pretty good, even though they're splooting. But you can see she's trying to get her legs up underneath her. Get her over here onto the... Come here, baby. There. Now you're on the carpet. See, she wants to get over to Mama. So it is encouraging her to use her back legs. And she is trying to use her back legs and move. Normally you'd be worried about them not using their back legs as much, but you can see when she bends it up, how she bends it in the proper, you can see how she's bending it in the proper direction. So that tells me that instead of just being, of there being a problem with their legs, that it's a fat problem and them just not having enough strength. See, she's nearly got herself up. That means she just doesn't have enough strength to lift her body fat up. So, if she stops nursing off of Piper so much and getting so much milk off of Piper, she will start utilizing their legs a little bit more, because they'll slim down just a tiny bit by not having as much milk. And they could do with a little bit of a slim down. It's not going to hurt them. But we'll still do a semi-slow wean. Won't be as slow as it would have been, but since they're both staying here with us and not going anywhere, well, I mean, he's going to go somewhere, but we have time on him. He doesn't have to leave at 6 weeks. That's what I'm getting at. He's not going anywhere at 6 weeks since I have to take him to my son. So we have plenty of time to allow them to wean properly and do all that. And normally with puppies that were, you know, normally if they weren't staying here, they would probably wait until they were 8 or 9 weeks before they would go, because I would want them to make sure that they were eating food properly and doing all that stuff properly before they went anywhere. And normally with my slow wean, that's around 6 to 7 weeks, but because these guys just haven't hit their little milestones because they're so fat, it's gonna be a little bit longer. But you can tell even with him, when he's trying to use his legs, he is bringing his legs up in the correct position. He's just not able to lift his body fat. And when I say these puppies are fat, I know they look fat on camera. He's pushing probably a good 5 pounds. I mean, he's fat. These guys are super, super chunky. And so it's just, he doesn't have the strength to lift his back end up. But you can see how he's using his legs in the proper directions. So if you have a puppy that has the splayed leg or kind of the fish legs, which happens sometimes in bulldogs and like some of the other large, like heavy breed dogs, like bulldogs, the French bulldogs, things like that. That's a different type of problem. So these legs would be more out, and instead of being able to bring them up underneath like this, they would only be able to, I can't demonstrate it because these guys aren't doing it, but they would basically, their legs would be out like this, and they would just go like this and waddle. But you can see how he's bringing his legs up into the correct positions. He's just doesn't have the strength to do it. And so we've been helping them like get their legs up into position, which is helping giving them some strength in their legs. It's just, he's so fat. So when I pick him up, I can't like pick him up and curl him under like a puppy, you know, like support his back end and curl him like a puppy. He's just so fat that his body doesn't really bend, which is another reason why he's having issues. But you can see when he's laying like this, how his legs are going straight back. That's another indication that he doesn't have the waddle problem, because if his legs weren't going straight back and his legs were all just bowing out to the side like this, but both of them all the time, I mean, they'll do that, but that's kind of a sploot. But see, his legs will go straight back. If their legs were doing the other thing all the time, that would be another issue. But because that's not what they're doing. Look, he knows there's food over here. I fed Piper. That's her water bowl that she's drank all the water out of. And I fed her, but he can smell the food. And he's over here like sniffing at food because Mama's not here to give him any food. And he can't really eat this, as it's not puppy food. But it's a good indication he's ready to start weaning. So they will start weaning this week. And I'll probably do another video like for their first time feeding. And we'll do that for their first time feeding. But anyway, they're doing really good. I gotta go put the bed thingy into the dryer. I just washed it. So I gotta get it into the dryer so I can change this out. And probably from once they start weaning, I'll have to start changing this thing every day. Right now I'm changing it every other day, as long as she's keeping it clean. But I can tell now that they're starting to pee a little bit more often, and so it's kind of yucky. So what we're gonna probably start doing from here on out is it'll start getting changed out every single day. And these little mats are fantastic because they're waterproof, and so like the bottom of the plastic that they're on doesn't get wet, and then then I can totally wash these. So we're gonna get that. I gotta go throw my other one into the dryer and get it dry, and then we'll get this cleaned out for them.
Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on, go play. Hey now, you're a rock star. Get the show on, get paid.
And all that glitters is gold.
Only shooting stars break the mold.
Oh, don't fall, Jelly.
So I thought I'd update on the puppies. This is their first time outside. They're going tomorrow to get their shots. And that they're doing really, really good. Like they're walking around and playing. Hello. And enjoying all this outside. It's pretty out here today, in the sun anyway. But they're doing really good. So they were 6 weeks old on Saturday. It's Monday. And they're gonna go get shots tomorrow. They'll get wormed again with a different type of wormer. And then we're gonna start working on probably next week, putting them in a smaller crate and work on beginning to house train. And begin house training probably here in the next, I don't know, 2 weeks sometime before the end of the month. Somebody's going to be either me or my husband. Somebody's going to make a trip to California to take Ozzy to our son. I think we've decided that we can just get on a plane.
Don't worry, be happy now.
And fly out there and drop them off. And
don't
drop
worry,
off.
Be happy. Don't worry, be happy.
This is Sage. He is my Chromatopelma cynopubescens, or GGB. I'm going to try to get a good look at him. He is confirmed male, not mature yet. Let me see if I can pop parts of this. Maybe I can open it up a little bit. He tends to be very flighty, but we'll see. And he's weighed heavily. There he is. See, pretty blue on his legs. He's got a green carapace that you can't really see, and then pretty orange butt.
All right, so next up is going to be Sage, my Chromatopelma cynopubescens, or green bottle blue. He didn't eat last time. I'm thinking he's going to be starting in pre-molt. Normally, he always eats, but as he's gotten bigger, when he gets close to molting, he stops eating. So I'm going to guess if he doesn't eat this time, I'm probably going to be getting a molt here in the next little bit. But we will see. We're going to try to give him a small one. And at the very least, he's been more sluggish, so I'm thinking he's definitely pre-molty. Yeah, his booty looks very pre-molty. But you can see how pretty. There's that green carapace and the blue legs and the orange booty. He is confirmed male. So. Oh, no. He's definitely not going to eat it. That's definitely a sign that he's not eating. So we're going to get that roach out of there and let him go. All right, so the other one that molted was my GGB. Look at those colors. The blue on the legs. He's looking so pretty. He didn't hook out yet, so that's good. Get a little bit more time with him. His molt was... Hold on, let me go look. All right, so his molt was just over 4 inches. And there he goes. He molted about 2 weeks ago. And he ate last week. So this is his second feeding after the molt. He is doing really good.
Okay, so it's cold and early in the morning, but we're going to be adding goats to the farm. I happened to make a comment that, you know, it would be nice that I like goats, and goats would be a lot of fun to have. A goat, or two, you know. And the next thing I know, my husband bought 8. So, yeah, we have 8 goats coming today, here in a couple hours. So, he didn't think of the logistics of having goats. He bought 8 Nigerian dwarf pygmy crosses. So those are the teeny tiny goats. And he didn't think of the logistics of that, and the fact that our pasture is done with barbed wire, and goats will go right through barbed wire. So for right now, I'm gonna stick them on this side of the dog kennels where I have, where Lucifer and Buddy are. So I'm gonna put Lucifer and Buddy over into the large side. So they'll have this whole large side, which is still really big. And then they'll have their building for their food and their bedding, where they can sleep and have their food at. And then on the smaller side, which is actually still a really good size, the goats will be over here, and then they'll have this building, which I'll string a, because I've got 2 babies. One mama's got 2 babies on her that I think were born right before Christmas. And then I've got 2 other mamas that are pregnant, and I don't know when they're going to be delivering, but it'll be too cold for baby goats. So I'll string, I'm getting jumped on by the dogs. So I'll string I'll string a heat lamp and put in here in the barn for the baby goats. And then I'll fill that up with hay for them so they can, stay warm. And then we've already got somebody coming today, to give us a quote on, wrapping our entire property with goat wire, or with goat panels, to so that way the goats can have pasture to run on. I'll have to supplement them with some hay. They will eat a lot of this. So goats like to eat trash, like trash hay. So they'll eat a lot of this, and there's like a lot of like, this is like weedy stuff, and that's exactly what goats like to eat. So they'll probably eat a lot of this. There is some green, I don't know if you can see it. There's some green back there, but they probably won't eat that. But for the winter time, I'll have to supplement them. Well, for as long as they're in this part, I'll have to supplement them with some hay and then some goat pellets, things like that. I'll have to do some things for them. I don't really have anything for them to climb on. I'll have to figure out some things for them to climb on and to play on here in the next like couple of weeks. I'll have to figure out some stuff like that for them to climb on and play on. But for the first couple of weeks, they'll just be settling in. And anyway, I know it's not, I've heard from a couple other goat people, because I've talked to some goat people, that it wasn't really the best time for somebody to decide to sell goats that are going to have babies sometime soon, because goats tend to stress. But I don't know. I was not really involved in the whole thing, other than saying, I guess, if bring the goats. So now I'm going to figure out how to do it. So what I'm going to do to keep Lucifer and Buddy don't jump the fence, but just for added security, because dogs and goats don't mix well. So what I'm going to do is I've already turned off the hot wire, but I have hot wire anyway that ran along this side of the fence, that I had originally when we had some other dogs out here, that when they would get over there with over into that side with a different dog, they would fight. And so I put up the hot wire to keep them from trying to go under the fence, because that's what they were doing. They were digging underneath the fence. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take all of this down, and I'm going to put it on Buddy and Lucifer's side. So that way it will give a little added security for Buddy and Lucifer from trying to jump over and get to the goats. So that will protect the goats from Buddy and Lucifer. And then once the cattle panels are all up along in the pasture, that'll keep the other dogs that run loose from being able to get into the pasture to get to the goats. And then I've already talked to a friend of mine who also has goats, and she said she thinks she can get me an adult, a young adult or Great Pyrenees that can go out with the goats and the alpacas and protect the goats and the alpacas, since the llamas don't really do a good job of it. She did say she thinks that the llamas might start protecting with the goats once the goats are out there. But I don't really know. Right now the llamas don't do crap to protect the alpacas. So I'm thinking that if I get a Great Pyrenees and put out there, at least that way they'll be protected from coyotes, as we do have a lot of coyotes out here. So that will protect the goats. And then I will just, at night, I'll just lock the goats up in the barn area at night. So that's where all that's at. So I'm gonna start doing this because the goats are already on their way, and I don't know how long before they get here. And as long as I got Lucifer and Buddy on that side, I can continue to work out here. I want to get them moved over, and I need to get their food moved over, because right now their food is in this building, and this building is set up for them to sleep in. So I need to move their food from this building to this building, and I need to get this gate secured, so that way they're over there, and when the goats come in, I don't have to worry about the dogs being over here. And then I have to go and get, I only have one of these water troughs in here, so I'm gonna have to go get another. I'm gonna have to go get my other water trough that I have, and put that over for Buddy and Lucifer on Buddy and Lucifer's side. So I'll have to do that. But anyway, that's what I'm getting ready to do. Okay, so it's been a couple days since the goats got here, but there was a lot of work to get done and a lot of things to get them settled in. But I will show you all the goats. So we put this divider up for the boys to keep the boys separated from the girls, mainly because we have this little girl right here, and she's old enough to be bred. Well, she's old enough to get bred, not be bred, but get bred. She shouldn't be bred until next year, but she's super tiny, and these guys are super big, so we don't want her to accidentally get pregnant. And then this one just had babies that they pulled the babies off of her. This one, I don't know if she's pregnant, and there's another one inside there that I'll show you in a minute. But anyway, so we did this divider for the boys. We built this little lean-to, and there are 3 dog boxes in there with hay in it. So that one over there, his name is Bobo. It used to be Fritz, but we changed it to Bobo. This guy, I don't remember what his name was originally, but we are now calling him Mr. Sifu. So those are the 2 intact males. This little one right here, I'm trying to get a picture. This little one right here is Luna. This one behind her is Sterling. He is 4 weeks old, and I'm kind of bottle feeding him. So at night, both of these 2 go in the house, because they're not letting them go inside the building is like they should. And I'm needing to watch him extra carefully because he is being bottle fed, and they didn't give me his mama. So this one, we're gonna change some of their names They were calling this one Brownie. She's a female. Like I said, this one's a female. They took her babies from her. So I'm watching her closely. This one is the withered male. That means he's been sterilized. His name is Charming. And there's one more inside the barn. I'll show you. I did put a light in here to keep them warm. But
you can see she's in there laying down. And she's super friendly, but she's also pretty close to delivering. They said she's due in April. I don't know. From what I've heard, though, moving them into, moving them at this point in pregnancy can stress them out. So I don't know. I'm hoping she will keep the babies in long enough that that the babies will be okay. But she's super, super friendly. Luna is super, super friendly, the little one. Sterling is not so friendly, but hopefully with me messing with him constantly, since I'm having to bottle feed him, he'll get more friendly. This one's not too bad on being friendly. These other two, not so much. The boys will come up to you when you're feeding and messing with them, and they're pretty good. So far, they don't seem to mind the dogs, really. And the dogs really only bark if I'm out here. I've noticed, like, yesterday, the dogs weren't barking at all as long as I wasn't out here. So this is where they're at for right now. They will get moved out into the pasture. We've got somebody that's going to be coming and putting goat panel up in the entire pasture, around all the entire pasture, so the goats would have full run of the pasture just like the alpacas do. The boys will be on the boys' side and the girls will be on the girls' side. And we are probably going to sell Sterling, because Sterling, so all of these are pygmy, let's see, they're Nigerian dwarf pygmy crosses. He is a Nubian cross, which means he can't be bred to any of these females. So we're most likely going to just sell him off to a pet home. And I'll probably, be nice to him. That's one reason why at night they, the two babies get brought into the house at night, is because I don't want them to not let the babies inside the barn, and I don't want the babies sleeping out here where it's cold. The barn with the light is warm, but out here it would be way too cold for them. During the day it's not so bad, and they are letting them go inside during the day, but I'm just not sure about nighttime. And so I don't want to take any chances with the two babies. Luna is 9 months old. She's not a baby. She'll actually be able to breed next year. We're probably going to go ahead and just sell Sterling to a pet home, because he's not going to be able to be bred with any of these other girls. And so it seems like it would be better if he was just in a pet home where he could be more loved on. So pick on him, but they're not really being too mean. They just kind of try to butt a little bit, but I've noticed they're not being too mean to him. Yesterday, he was inside the building yesterday, and he's doing fine. So, dang it, one of the dogs got in here. I gotta get her out. She won't really hurt him. That's Athena. They're more apt to, like, get her, but I'm gonna get off here now and I'm gonna get her out. I don't know how she managed to get in here. None of the other dogs can get in here, but I'm gonna get her out. She's just freaking small, so she probably just squeezed through something. So I'm gonna get her out, and it'd probably serve her right if she got butted once. That'd probably keep her away from here on out. But anyway, I'm gonna get her out, and these are the goats. Phenomena. Phenomena.